Okay, this is part two in a series on 2D game design using Phaser 2D. If you didn't watch the last video in this series, I definitely recommend watching it. Go ahead and check out the playlist. Hopefully there's a link in the description to the full playlist. Now, last video was kind of long. Hopefully this video will be a little bit shorter, but we're going to do some fun things. We're going to add physics to our players. So far, we have two players here. One there and one there using our player's function here. Let's go ahead and add physics to our game. So we're going to come in here and under our create function, so while the game is being created, what we're going to do is we're going to say, okay, find our game, and we're going to add in some physics. So games, our game.physics.start the system. Now, Phaser has different types of physics systems, at least three different types. We're doing the most basic here, which is the least system hungry when it comes to resources, and that would be arcade physics. So basically each character is going to have an invisible square around them that indicates their boundaries. So our Tux isn't going to have, you know, a boundary that matches around the image like this. It basically has an invisible square that is the boundary of the image, which is good enough for the game that we're creating here. So again, we're saying here, take the game that we created using our Phaser library up here. So that game, that object, we're going to call the physics function and start the physics system, and we're going to say use the physics system of arcade. Okay, so now we have physics in our game, but we need to tell the game that our players, all of our players, need to have those physics applied to them, because not everything in your game is going to have physics. So I'm going to come down here to our create function, and after we've created our players group, we're going to say, take our players group and dot enable body. And remember, this is case sensitive, so write it like I'm writing it, and we're going to say set it to true. So now, any player that we add to the players group will have physics, but you can have different physics for different players because there's different parameters for each player. So let's come down to our create function here, our create player function, and we're gonna say in here, take the player, not players, but player that we created on the line above right here, and we're gonna say, look at its body, which was created with the physics that we've added to it. And we're going to say that we want it to bounce. So bounce on the y-axis. So that's up and down. X is left and right. Y is up and down. And how much do we want to bounce? We'll say 0.2. So a little bit of a bounce. And that's not going to do anything at this point because the player isn't falling. You know, the player isn't moving. So let's go ahead and add player.body, so we're going to add to the player's body dot gravity on the y-axis. So we're going to say, ready, I'm going to put in, just from my notes, I have 300. So obviously if you want them to fall faster, make that number bigger. So first, let's go ahead and actually comment out our bounce line. We should have done the gravity line first, just as an example. So now I can restart this, and you can see our player falls and keeps falling. So it didn't stop and it didn't bounce. Well, for it to bounce, it needs something to bounce off of. And we're gonna add a ground plane later on, but for right now, we're gonna say player.body.collide world bounds equals true. So our world is a certain size. And so our player, without this, the player will go off screen, left, right, up, down, the world's not gonna stop it. But with this set to true, we'll save that, and now our player will fall, both our players will fall, and stop when they get the bomb. But they just kind of stop. Yeah, so now we'll uncomment our bounce property here. So we're saying that it has a property of bouncing, which by default is set to zero, but we're gonna turn it up a little bit to 0.2. And now they bounce a little bit. Now obviously if we were to turn this number up instead of 0.2, we'll just make it 2. Let's save that and refresh. Oh no, they're bouncing up and down like crazy. Okay, let's do 1. Let's see how much that is. Falling, falling, falling. Okay. They almost hit the top again. But they didn't. And they're going to bounce and bounce. And they're going to see they're going to bounce. Let's change this to 0.5. Just 0.5. You can type 0.5 or just 0.5. It doesn't care. There we go. You can see it bounces, bounce, bounce till they come to a stop. But I like 0.2 in my notes. That's what I found to work the best. And there we go. We have players that bounce with a little bit of physics. So let's go ahead and make this full screen so you can see. Shrink things down just a little bit so you can see all the code. So just to quickly review, we create our game with some parameters up here. We preload. Right now we're preloading one image. Just means that we're putting that image in, making sure it's downloaded in RAM so it's ready to load. Setting the background color here using hex code. Then we're setting that our game has physics. You gotta say that the game is gonna have physics so it enables that physics engine. We're creating a group for our players. And then we're saying that any player in the players group has a body enabled set to true. So this is saying physics has bodies, so you can add physics, but also collision, which we're going to get into. Right now it's colliding with the world, but we're going to collide with ground planes and other objects and stuff in the near future. Then we're creating two players, setting different coordinates for each of them, which is all done here. We haven't even done anything in our update function because all the updates we've had right now are handled by the physics engine. But we'll get into more of that later. So anyway, I thank you for watching. Again, this is part of a series. Now, someone's going to ask, because they always do, I can't find the next video in this series. Well, there's a link to a playlist in the description of this video. And if you can't access that because it's marked as private, that's because it's not going to be released until next week. I'm putting out one video each week. Now, if you are a Patreon supporter, you can get videos early. So think about becoming a supporter over at patreon.com/MetalX1000. And there for you can support me minimal financially. $1 a month is much appreciated. If you can't support me financially, but you like my videos, be sure to like, subscribe, share, and comment. That way you don't miss any videos, but it also helps boost the popularity of my videos a little bit. As always, please visit my website, filmsbychris.com. That's Chris the K. There should be a link to that in the description as well. And as always, I hope that you have a great day.